We'll begin this lesson by opening a new blank workbook. Excel has helpfully created a workbook, unimaginatively named Book 1. If you already have a workbook open called Book 1, the new workbook will be called Book 2, and so on. Notice that Book 1 Excel is displayed on the title bar. We're now going to create another new blank workbook. To do that, I click the File button at the top left of the screen. And then I click the New button on the left-hand menu bar. Then I'll click the Blank Workbook template. Now you could be forgiven for thinking that nothing had happened, but you can see that the title bar now says Book 2 Microsoft Excel, showing that you're now looking at a different new workbook. We'll now use the taskbar to move between workbooks. You'll see an Excel icon with two right-hand borders at the bottom of the screen. Hover over this icon with the mouse, and you'll see a gallery showing two workbooks, Book 1 and Book 2, the two workbooks that are open at the moment. If I click on Book 1, the window will change to display the Book 1 workbook. Now, not much will happen because both workbooks are empty, but you'll notice the title bar changing from Book 2 to Book 1. I'll click on Book 1 now, and I'll click on Book 2, and back again to Book 1. At this point, I'm going to introduce a shortcut key that I use all the time. It makes it very easy to navigate between Excel workbooks when you have several workbooks open. It's not such a time saver when there's only two workbooks open, as there are now, but you may find yourself in a situation where you have a large number of workbooks open, perhaps 20 or 30, and it's very difficult to find the workbook you need. The shortcut key combination is Control-Tab. So I'll now hold down the Control key and I'll press the Tab key several times. And as I press the Tab key, notice what's happening at the top of the screen. We can see Book 1, Book 2, Book 1, Book 2, Book 1, Book 2. And if there were 30 workbooks, we could quickly scroll through all 30 workbooks until we find the workbook that we need. You can also find a workbook when many are open using the ribbon. Here's how this is done. I'll click the View tab on the ribbon, and in the Window group, I'll click Switch Windows. I'm then presented with a list of all currently open workbooks. At the moment, there's only two. So I can quickly change from one workbook, in this case Book 2, to another, Book 1. I'll click on Book 1 now, and when I do, you'll see the title bar change again. I'll click Book 1 now, and I'm now viewing the Book 1 workbook. Next, I'm going to display both Book 1 and Book 2 at the same time. To do that, I click View on the ribbon, and in the Window group, Arrange All. I'm then presented with the Arrange Windows dialog, and I can arrange them in four different ways. Well, I'd like one window to be on top of the other window. So I'll click the horizontal option and then click OK. And you can see that both workbooks now fill exactly half of the screen each, and I can see both the Book 1 and the Book 2 workbook, one on top of the other. Notice that there's a slight difference between them. The title bar for Book 1 displays normally, but for Book 2, the title and the icons to the right are both greyed out. That's because Book 1 is currently the active workbook. If I click inside Book 2, I'll do that now, Book 2 becomes the active workbook. The title bar lights up, and the title bar for Book 1 is now greyed out. I'm now going to close Book 2 and maximise Book 1 to restore the display to a single workbook. You'll remember that we covered maximising windows back in Lesson 1-4. So if I want to close Book 2, I need to first click in Book 2 to make sure it's the active window. Then I can click the Close button at the top right-hand corner. And now I'll maximise Book 1 to the normal way of working, with the Excel application filling the screen. And to do that, I'll click the Maximise button. You've now completed Lesson 2-2. Create a new workbook and view two workbooks at the same time.